Students, we were studying the types of chemical reaction, and so far we have studied the combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, and double displacement reaction. And now we are studying the redox reaction. But before that, we have to understand two things, which are oxidation and reduction. Firstly, we will understand what is oxidation. A reaction which involves either addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen is known as oxidation. Now students, have a look on the example here. Carbon plus oxygen gas gives CO2. This reaction is of burning of coal. In this reaction, you can see that oxygen has been added to carbon. That is why this reaction is a oxidation reaction. Now, moving to the next, reduction process. A reaction which involves removal of oxygen or addition of hydrogen is known as reduction. Have a look on the example. Nitrogen plus hydrogen gives ammonia, NH3. Here, hydrogen gas has been added to nitrogen gas. That is why this process is a reduction process. Now students, a reaction in which both oxidation and reduction occur simultaneously is known as redox reaction. Let's understand redox reaction with the help of an activity. Here in this activity, we are heating copper powder in presence of air. When you take copper powder in a china dish and start it heating, you will observe that the reddish brown colored copper powder will turn to black. The chemical reaction involving in this process is Cu plus O2 gives CuO. This copper oxide is black in color. Now students, if you react this copper oxide with hydrogen gas and heat it, then you will see the black colored compound will again convert to reddish brown colored compound, and in this reaction the other product formed is water. So here you can see that copper oxide is turning into copper. It has lost its oxygen, so the process is reduction. And hydrogen get changed to H2O and it has added oxygen to it. That's why the process is oxidation. In this reaction, oxidation process and reduction process both are taking place simultaneously. That is why this process is redox reaction. So we can say that copper oxide get reduced and hydrogen get oxidized. I will introduce two more terms for you, which are oxidizing agent and reducing agent. You have to keep in mind these things as they are very important. Students, oxidizing agent is that substance which helps other substance to get oxidized, and this oxidizing agent itself get reduced. So here, out of your reactants, the substance which got reduced was copper oxide. So copper oxide is a oxidizing agent. Similarly, reducing agent is that substance which help other substance to get reduced, and this reducing agent itself get oxidized. Here in this reaction, hydrogen was the substance which got oxidized and help other substance to got reduced. That is why this is our reducing agent. So this thing must be clear to you students. Let's have a look on other example of redox reaction. The very first is, when zinc oxide reacts with carbon, it forms zinc and carbon monoxide. In this reaction, students, you can easily tell that zinc oxide, ZnO, it's losing its oxygen and it becomes Zn. That is why it is undergoing reduction. Your carbon has turned to carbon monoxide. Here you can see addition of oxygen. That is why this is oxidation. Now, as we discussed about oxidizing agent and reducing agents, so this carbon is our, because this carbon has undergone oxidation, that is why this is our reducing agent. And this zinc oxide, द जिंक ऑक्साइड गॉट रिड्यूस्ड, सो इट इज़ अवर ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट. नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट द नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल. इन दिस एग्जाम्पल स्टूडेंट्स यू कैन सी हेयर लॉस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, सो द प्रोसेस इज रिडक्शन. नाउ लुक एट द HCl. HCl has changed to H2O. That is why it is oxidation. Now talking about oxidizing agents and reducing agents, the substance which got oxidized, that is known as reducing agent, and the substance which got reduced, it is our oxidizing agent. So students, you must have understood this topic very clearly. And you can easily found the oxidizing agents, reducing agents, the substance that got oxidized or reduced. That's all for today, students. But you have to keep one thing in your mind very clearly, which is in any reaction, reactants are those substances which go into the change. They undergo the change. That is why whatever we will answer, whether we have to answer that which is the substance got oxidized, who got reduced, what is oxidizing agent here, what is reducing agent, we will answer all these questions out of the reactants only, because copper oxide and hydrogen are the only substances which have gone change. They have oxidized, they are reduced, they are playing the role of oxidizing agents and they are playing the role of reducing agent. So you have to answer all these out of the reactants only.